We agonized over a lot of design decisions in Rainbow Six. We agonized over the fact that we had this complicated planning phase followed by the action phase, which no one had done before. We agonized over the fact that we weren't going to have any power-ups, that it was realistic combat, where you could be killed with one shot. No one had done that before, and we weren't sure that any of that was going to be fun. We thought it would be. We did tests actually using the Quake engine. We mocked up, we made like a little Rainbow Six Quake mod, and we played that a bunch of multiplayer, and that was a lot of fun, but then again, we weren't sure how the final game would be accepted. On Rogue Spear, at least, Gary and Greg Stelmach did an excellent job coming up with a formula based upon the physical characteristics of the weapons that allowed us to get all of our characteristics out and tweak them from there. So we did things like, what's the overall length of the weapon? What's the length of the barrel? What's the caliber of the round? What is the what's the effective kick of the weapon because of the powder load? You know, what's the rate of fire? We put all of these things, what's the weight of the gun? We put all of these things into a formula, and Greg sat there and tweaked and tweaked and tweaked and tweaked, and out of that we got all of our reticle constants and things like that that affect things in the game, which was great. And then we played around with that, with those variables, until we got something that played well, or was close, and then we play tested it ourselves and said, oh, you know, even though the formulas are pumping out this, we want this, it doesn't feel like there's enough of a difference with this weapon. So that's basically how we did it. The first real sign that we had something truly kind of magical on our hands was E3 of 98, it must have been. When we showed up at E3, we had crammed everything in there like crazy to get it all working at its most basic level. And we had two levels that we could play. We had the Congo and the Embassy. And over the course of the 3 days of E3, we had constantly like huge crowds. We had people coming back and back and back. And we'd have people come through once, and then they'd go away and come back with more friends, and then they'd come back with their bosses in suits, you know. And it became kind of like it was really rejuvenating, and we came away from that saying that we have a great product, and yeah, it's going to do great if people get access to it, if they can hear about it.